I have brought with me an amazing tactical idea which will astonish you 100%. And before we come to the moves, let's just do what you should do in a chess game, evaluate the position. As you can see, the white player has a king on e2, which looks a little bit awkward, but actually it is pretty safe here as long as the center doesn't open up and these pieces on d7 and e7 get activated. And I really don't see how this could happen. So therefore we can say that white's king is rather safe. But what about black's king? Let's take a look at this king here. And it looks like it's a little bit less safe because there is this idea of d takes e6 check and the king must react. So the material is equal, the distribution of the material is not equal because white has the pair of bishops on e3 and a4, while black has a knight on d7 and a bishop on e7. So at the same time, we can say that white pieces are slightly more active. There is also a lot of tension in the center. The pawns are attacking each other and vice versa. So it looks a little bit complicated. Now, another very important feature of this position, or in general, unprotected pieces. I see a rook on g1, which is unprotected, a queen on a1, and this is pretty much everything notable in white's camp, which is not defended. And black has a rook on a8, which is unprotected, and also this pawn on e6 looks a little bit weak, and it is white's turn. So what should white play here? Well, just imagine you had two moves. There is a very simple idea which might not catch your attention immediately. This is first bishop c6 and then d takes e6 check, and suddenly the king cannot take back the pawn because there is this mate. Let's just take a look. So bishop to c6. Rook to a safe square, let's say b8. D takes e6, a double attack against the king and the knight on d7. The bishop on c6 is unprotected for the moment, but this does not matter because it's check and the king shouldn't really take because of bishop to d5 check. So this is not working because this check is also a checkmate. So white has to play something else. Let's say king to f8, and now you can see that white can just capture the knight on d7 with the bishop, and suddenly the bishop on d7 is protected because white just took on e6. I was really amazed by this idea, and especially because I found it in a game which guaranteed me a rather easy win. Let me know your opinion about this sort of chess tactic. Have you ever encountered a similar idea?